Couldn't be more thrilled. Welcome back to the show. Someone I haven't talked to for far too long. One of my favorite people, the host of the Course Correction Podcast, Nelufar Hedayat. Welcome back to the Damage Report.
It's a pleasure.
We're very glad to have you here. It's been a whole pandemic since we last spoke, but I do remember one of your previous appearances on the show was to talk about the launch of your podcast, which is now well into its second season. By the time people are seeing this, I believe 9 episodes will be available. And I'm assuming that some of the people watching this interview might not be familiar with our last talk. So tell me a little bit about Course Correction.
Who are these people? I want names. I want a list. happy to be on your show again, John. I miss you. Having not been able to travel as much as I do as a filmmaker and a documentarian, I've had to learn to adapt. And podcasts seem to be the way forward. Everyone's got one. So I thought I'll stick my all in. Course Correction Season 2 is basically following in the steps of Season 1. We go to places, we do things that other people shy away from. And most of that is to do with trying to make sure that you step in to the shoes that you want to see filled. So when we're talking about the plastic crisis, the scourge in our oceans, when we're talking about trying to talk to people we disagree with, or trying to heal the polarization divide that is sweeping across the globe, from India to Indiana through to Iran, wherever you might look, this is common. So Season 2 focuses on the polarization issue. And I ended up speaking to people on the right, on the left, on the far right, not so much for the far right, for the far left, and everywhere in between, really trying to really grapple with this idea of like, what has got us to a place where it is easier to sit on the internet and yell at each other than to speak to our neighbors.
Yeah, well, right there, you are perfectly describing my career. But anyway, no. Yeah, it's obviously important to speak to people that we disagree with. I notably choose not to do that for the most part, but I am obviously very happy that you do. So look, you talk about a lot of different topics through the course of just the episodes that have been released, from robots to lockdown, fake news, reparations, free speech, like a billion different things. What is the case where there's been the biggest gap between your position on an issue and the person that you're talking to or profiling in Course Correction?
Muslims, specifically Muslim women people and the French law, the European law that is trying to decide and police women's bodies. So we started to make an episode on what's creeping into the democracies of Western Europe, whereby they are starting to tell Muslim women that they can and cannot wear headscarves. And these are bills and laws that to some degree have been passed, but the French Senate has shown some way towards wanting to ban the hijab in public spaces for girls and for women. And this episode, I started off telling myself that I don't care. I'm just like, I don't wear that headscarf. It's nothing to do with me. I'm a liberated Western Muslim woman and all this. And by the end of it, I have to say, I was so outraged that I cried tears of rage for the first time. And I sat across the mic. You know, it's really hard to talk about something as personal as religion, a headscarf, and a democracy telling you, you will be liberated. We will free you by forcing you to take it off. And I started off not caring. And I spoke to a French lawmaker, Aurore Berge, who said she wants to liberate all Muslim women by forcing them to take the hijab off. And you know what? I sat there and I did everything that we at Doha Debates Course Correction does. I opened myself up, I tried to listen, and I learned that actually I have more in common with her than I don't. But the things I disagree on, boy, do I disagree on it. So podcast doesn't shy away from disagreement. What it shies away from is just shouting at one another. I am genuinely sick of turning on CNN, MSNBC, sometimes the BBC and other outlets across the world, and hearing just one person going this, that, and the other, and the poor journalist in the middle going, but there's another side, turning around and like hearing from it's not cool. So we really take this whole don't settle for a divided world thing very seriously at Doha Debates, and Course Correction is a reflection of that. I've had to sit across the laptop from people that I genuinely disagree with. So whether it's the Lacey Tay episode in which we talk about policing women's body and like feminism and liberalism in France, through to, as you mentioned, free speech, like when is free speech not free speech, you know? And I learned a lot about the fact that I actually I don't care about free speech as much as I thought I did. You know, I'm from Afghanistan. I'm born into a country where dressing a certain way, talking a certain way, being a certain sex or gender can be enough to get you killed. And I thought I cared so much about the liberty of free speech. I don't. I think we should curb it. So listen, you're gonna listen to these episodes of Course Correction. I'm gonna change my mind and I'm gonna be the little piggy that gets out there and gets tossed in to have the fights that you don't wanna have. So tune in, it's good.
That is a great tagline for the show. A little piggy gets tossed into gigantic online debates. Anyway, yeah, no, I have, you know, all the admiration in the world for that. I like to think that I am still mentally flexible enough and expose myself to enough to gradually shift on some things over time. But I can't necessarily easily identify a couple of gigantic shifts like that. So, you know, more power to you. Well, look, it's always great to catch up with you, especially when you're doing such fascinating work. And everyone watching this needs to check it out. Obviously, the podcast Course Correction available pretty much everywhere. I use Pocket Cast, but feel free to check your podcast browser of choice. And Nelufar, always glad to have you on the show, and hopefully you'll be back in LA sometime soon.
Yes, catch you there.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Cast or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.